your service. I'm Julia Morica with The World Today.
When I am an old woman, I shall wear purple with a red hat which doesn't go and doesn't suit me. And I shall spend my pension on brandy and summer gloves and satin sandals and say, we've no money for butter. I shall sit down on the pavement when I'm tired and gobble up samples in shops and press alarm bells and run my stick along the public railings and make up for the sobriety of my youth. I shall go out in my slippers in the rain and pick flowers in other people's gardens and learn to spit.
The poem Warning by Jenny Josephs. Now, most of us would agree we get wiser as we get older, but do we also get more stylish? The fashion world is bursting with young, beautiful models, but it's a rarity to find a woman over the age of 40 strutting the catwalks of Paris or Milan. But is it time that we all started to appreciate the more mature woman's sense of style? Well, Ari Cohen is a fashion photographer and the creator of the fashion blog Advanced Style, which is dedicated to trendy, older women. And he joins me from Seattle. Ari, welcome to the programme.
Good morning.
Tell us why your interest was sparked here.
It really started as a child. I was best friends with my grandparents, and my grandmothers had a profound influence upon me. They were full of life. They treated me like an equal, and I really saw their spirit, and we spent so much time together. I moved to New York about 3 years ago and saw so many women, like in their 80s and 90s, walking around, you know, dressed up in leopard suits and beautiful hats and gloves, and I mean, they look better than any young girl that I saw on the street. So I really wanted to show people that style doesn't end at a certain age, and style really is a reflection of people's own vitality.
Now, it's one thing to see these women in New York and admire them. It's quite another to go up to them and say, would you mind if I take your photograph?
Yeah, I mean, it started out, I was a little nervous, but now it's gotten really easy. I think everyone likes to be complimented. So, you know, I start out by telling them what I appreciate about them, and I'll kind of say to a woman who might be 90, you know, I photograph women 50 and over, and she goes, oh my God, well, I'm 95. So really, it's about giving respect and kind of making these women who haven't been, you know, kind of appreciated for a long time, visibility and appreciation for the way they dress, the way that they express themselves, their personal style, their art form.
So you've never had a bad reaction?
Here and there, but generally it's really positive. Yeah, I mean, they're so willing to share their stories and their wisdom. I hear great comments every day.
Tell me about men as well. I mean, are you photographing them, or is this purely the older woman?
A little bit of both, but I tend to feature more women than men.
Because they're more stylish?
I wouldn't say that. Just I think that it's more my connection with my own, my grandmother's was so strong that I'm kind of, you know, more drawn to their style, I guess.
And via your website, you have now built up a significant now selection of photographs, a body of work, haven't you?
Yeah, I'm working on a book that's going to be out in spring 2012, about 200 photos and wisdom from these ladies. I mean, they have the most incredible things to say that can inspire anyone from a 12-year-old girl to an 85-year-old woman. And so, yeah, I've been doing it about 3 years now.
Right. Well, I know both Jeffrey and Carmen are listening to you with interest. Carmen, what do you make of this?
I just love this. You know, Julie and I work a little in the fashion magazine world myself. Mm. And so I applaud anybody that's bringing someone, you know, especially older women, into the picture, because apart from anything else, we have in the West huge, massively aging populations. So this fixation on youth is becoming, apart from anything else, kind of inappropriate. Increasingly, people are not going to be able to relate to these images. So I think that we have to celebrate diversity in all its forms. And for, you know, women who do routinely become kind of invisible after a certain age, I think it's absolutely wonderful. I mean, I've seen your website, and I see that these ladies, I mean, they're eccentrics, right? They're not shrinking violence.
Yeah, they really have a sense of freedom as they've gotten older, because they believe that there are no rules. Like, the rule is that there are no rules. You know, they could do whatever they want at this point, and really they dress for themselves, which I think is really great when you see a lot of younger people who are sort of insecure and trying to figure out who they are. These women know who they are and really have nothing left to prove to anyone.
That's right. I think young people are so crippled by insecurities, and you can see from the pictures that you've got up on your blog that these ladies, they don't care, you know, and they're just celebrating themselves and fashion and loving what they're doing. And it is a strike against this invisibility in society, I think, too. Mm-hmm.
Jeffrey, do you applaud this from Nairobi?
Oh yeah, I thought it was wonderful, and I would love to see you come to Africa and try to photograph some of the old folks here.
That would be amazing.
I think that would be great.
Yeah, you ought to put that on your agenda, Ari, perhaps.
Hey, I'll go anywhere. I want to feature women all over the world.
I wasn't sure whether Jeffrey was offering to pay for the trip, but it sounded a very warm invitation nonetheless. I just wanted to touch on this idea, Carmen, that you mentioned about the lack of visibility of women above a certain age in fashion publications. Clearly, presumably the reason is that people don't think they will sell.
Yes, I imagine that's the reason. I wonder about that, though, because, of course, unless we give people a choice, we have no idea how they're going to respond. So if we, personally, I find the fact that every fashion or style magazine looks much like the next quite boring. And I think it would actually be much more creative, and given that the fashion press is all about creativity, to start to bring in some different notions of beauty. I think we're very limited at the moment.
And so it says something about quality to show a woman who's like 90 years old, who's been wearing, you know, Oil of Olay products for how many, 50 years. You know, that really says something about the brand, that it withstands the test of time.
And it's true. I'm quite surprised that some of the major brands haven't picked up on this yet. But, you know, I'm sure they will. I'm sure this is just a matter of time. Fashion particularly is always looking for new markets. You know, now they're going for the preteens and for the kind of men's style press, and it can only be a matter of time until we get more and more into the mature lady.
Let me float these comments from some of our listeners into the mix by way of saying farewell to you, Ari. Brass Ashtalon Cecil in Oklahoma in the estate says, sadly my age group lacks style for the most part and needs to look to older people, the implication being that that's a younger person. Kedaris Hilmi in Barama in Somalia says, style doesn't come with age, it grows with you all the way from childhood to old age. If you see a stylish old lady, go back and see her stylishness in her youth. True, Ari, do you think?
Yeah, a lot of these women have always been stylish, but it's really, they've come into their own later on in life, so they've perfected what they do. So yeah, I think they've always had an interest, but they advance as they get older.
Very good to have you on the program.
Thank you very much indeed.
Ari Cohen, fashion blogger and photographer, joining us from Seattle. Now, Ari, thank you so much.
Oh, thank you, guys.
I hope you enjoyed that. We gave quite a long length for broadcast. So,
oh, great.
If you wanted to express yourself.
Thank you. That was perfect.
Yeah. Okay, cool. Well, you find out on our website, you should be able to.
Is that going to be online?
It will be online if you, but I'm trying to look if there are any restrictions, because let me have a think. If you search for The Weekend World Today, you should be able to find it. It's certainly broadcast all over the States on NPR in lots of complicated ways, but you'll have had quite a few American listeners here and there as well. And moreover, Pandita can send you an MP3 if you'd like her to do that.
Perfect. That'd be amazing.
Okay, take care. Well, good luck with it. Cheers.
Starting off at a market in the